It was 1950-something when the swine epidemic hit the county and eventually led to catastrophic shortage of Ruzel. And man, let me tell you, it was one hell of a disaster. Haircut spoke 1,000 words, the Ruzel was vanishing, leaving a price tag that only the upper class could handle. It was either no one of those loaded bastards or hope the Lord would hear your prayers. You see, folks were faced with one hell of a problem. Poor bastards started to lose control over their ladies. It was get Ruzel or get lost. But having that inviting smell of apple could get your pompadour in some serious trouble. Folks be taking it out, you see. Eventually, all that barbarism led to the death of Mr. Barbosa, or murder, as the local newspapers stated. The city was shocked and mourned for Mr. Barbosa, since he was known for his generosity and was a close partner of the mayor, financing many projects for the community. And so I decided to visit Miss Barbosa the same morning to tell her the bad news about her husband. Needless to say, she was surprised by my presence. I realized I didn't have anything sensible to say, so I passed Mr. Barbosa's remains that were found at the crime scene. Obviously, Ruzel free this time. Love that makes blind, they say, which made me wonder, was it love that caused Miss Barbosa's tears? Or was it just another charade from the Barbosa family? You see, to my knowledge, Mr. Barbosa was a merciless mobster who knew exactly how to keep folks under his thumb. The local barber had nothing to say, and collecting protection money was like a walk in the park. The bastard knew about the mayor's Ruzel addiction and had him right where he needed him. Not to mention, he even made the priest sell his soul to the devil. But if that wasn't enough, the son of a bitch targeted the Ruzel warehouses. A voice inside me insisted we have a proper conversation. And so, I visited Mr. Barbosa on a wonderful Monday evening, but I didn't come alone. I introduced him to a bitch called Karma. Now, eventually, he did change his mind on the matter and exposed his secret stocks, but I shot him anyway. Took me a week to dig those stocks up, worth 2,000 cans of Ruzel, which was enough for at least 1,000,000 pompadours. Should have checked his asshole before they buried the schmuck. Anyway, as a police detective, I was obliged by law to return to Ruzel Treasury. But hey, what if I wouldn't?